Tens of millions of Americans are set to vote for the next president of the United States in a tight race between Vice President Kamala Harris and former President Donald Trump. With the two candidates neck and neck, the outcome of the election is likely decided by just a handful of swing states where Republican and Democratic candidates have similar levels of support.
Whoever I vote for, I want them to respect me.
Us little people are the people. You shove us out and what have we got?
Once we've seen our bodily autonomy go, what comes next?
America can do better.
Here's what the battleground voters have to say about their hopes and fears for this election.
Everywhere you look, everything's upside down. Everything's backwards. Everything's how it shouldn't be.
Everyday average Americans can't put food on the table anymore. And there's families that are struggling.
Socioeconomic conditions of our world, along with what will happen with my daughter in the future. Socioeconomic meaning that she will have the opportunities to be a part of society. She will have the opportunity to see a woman candidate being hopeful the president of the United States. Those are the things that matter most to me.
Most of us, like the little people with the little mom and pop shops, they're gone and they won't be back because they can't afford it. Between inflation and taxes, the price hike, just rules, regulations, us little people are the people. You shove us out and what have you got?
Yeah, my biggest fear is just where the economy's going. Interest rates are at an all-time high. So whoever has, you know, the biggest plan to make the most impact, to make homes more affordable.
The policy where the border is open is absolutely obscene and these people aren't being vetted and women are being raped and there's tons of crime and there's a lot of destruction of neighborhoods and these people not respecting our country.
We are literally founded on the concept that this is a great place to be, to become whoever you want to be, to be kind, to be welcomed for whatever reason, to escape places that they can't be.
Making sure that whoever I'm voting for is going to create a future where the people I love and the people who are most marginalized are safe.
Geopolitics and the prospect that America might be at war, hot war, in the next 4 years.
What matters most to me when I go to cast my vote in November is human rights, but not just the human rights of those within our country, the human rights of those all over the world, including Palestine, including Congo, and including the Sudan.
Women's rights and bodily autonomy. Women's rights to find proper health care, treatment, finding birth control, and eventually our rights, because once we've seen our bodily autonomy go, what comes next?
I have a 12-year-old. He's a boy, and I worry that he's going to grow up in a world where he thinks that he's bad, you know, because he's like a white dude.
The climate crisis. I think that the climate crisis is the single biggest crisis that we really as a country and also as the world really face.
It's hard to prioritize too much higher than climate change. And fighting climate change is an issue. We could solve all the other problems if we don't address climate change, if we just all die, but that seems like not the solution we want.
I'm afraid that this country is just going into a wrong direction and maybe to a dead end. And we need to stop it. We need to change leadership. America can do better.
That Trump gets the win, this world's gone to crap. You know what I mean? We need somebody better in the seat.
What matters the most to me is having my voice heard. People that look like me, whether that be a person of color, a woman, a millennial, we really want our issues addressed and not just thrown by the wayside. We want to be heard and action taking place for our issues.
I would go for Trump. I think we need somebody in there that has, I can't say what I want to say, has the gumption, has the strength.
I'm so concerned that Donald Trump will become president and we don't know what will happen because he's such a loose cannon.
I do not like Trump and I just feel he's an ignorant person.
The economy, that's the number one issue. The economy, getting things back on track, getting inflation under control. Only President Trump can do that.
whoever I vote for, I want them to respect me. And that means I expect them to be kind, I expect them to be empathetic, I expect them to be competent, and I expect them to be strong in matters of taking care of people.